Hello, everyone. My name is Lachlan. I write for Monday Morning, and I'm also an analyst on Exponential Stock Investor. Now, we will do a bit of housekeeping first. First of all, I'd like to apologize for not creating some content for you over the last month. It's been an extremely long year, and we needed to take a little break just to get back into the swing of things properly. But with that being said, we are very excited to be bringing you new, hopefully better content over the coming year. We've been rejigging a few things. And I guess, first of all, these videos will be coming out on a Monday afternoon, generally, instead of, say, a Wednesday morning or something like that. So I guess keep your eyes peeled for that. Another reason why we've been away is I've had to do a lot of work for Exponential Stock Investor to get that primed for the new year. So I'd really encourage you to check that out if you get a chance. Now, that's a small cap newsletter. It's an excellent resource if you're into small caps. So let's just dive straight in. So the article, which you can find in the video description below, now that's all about the e-commerce and retail sector surge that I'm seeing in the market at the moment. So I'll just give you a bit of background. We'll look at e-commerce versus retail charts. Then I'll dive into some macro factors, some RBA charts, to sort of explain that trend. And then I will have a bonus discussion of a particular stock as a sort of example of how you would go about putting things on a watch list and thinking about how to invest based off of trends and second order effects. So I hope you stick around for this because that's going to be a good one, I think. Straight off the bat, I've got a headline here from the Sydney Morning Herald, which is talking about some ABS data, which is the Australian Bureau of Statistics. And it says the Australian economy is back growing again, swelling by 3.3% in the 3 months to the end of September. Now, that's published in December, as you can see. And I guess one of the main things I want to say straight off the bat is if it's in the news, it's already in the price. There are analysts out there who follow this stuff, and they are usually ahead of the data releases by a long way. You know, they can see this stuff coming. So let's just dive into some more traditional retailers and see what's happening on their charts. So I've got Super Retail Group Limited of Rebel Sports fame. So this, you can see a strong bounce off of March. This is nothing too surprising. And I guess my comments on this chart are, you can see it running into a bit of resistance around here, punching through that, dropping off. And then the old resistance sort of forms the new support. That's an old saying there, and it's punching higher. So I guess that's largely based on some macro tech trends, which I'll get to in a moment. Now I've also got JB Hi-Fi Limited here. Some reasonably strong upward momentum, as you can see. And it's a strong bounce. And then it's a similar chart to Super Retail Group. So it's the same situation where this support then becomes some resistance here, and it punches through again. So finally, I just, in the sort of more traditional retail stock category, is Nick Scali Limited. I'm not sure I pronounced that correctly, but this is a furniture retailer. So you can see it's just gone absolutely nuts over the last, I guess, 7 or 8 months. And it's even gapped up at times here on a few occasions. And then it found some support. There was a bit of sideways trading and it's now punching higher. So I'll just show you a couple announcements, which you can find on Newswire, which I'd also recommend you take a look at Market Index. I find it a bit more useful than the ASX website. It loads quicker, et cetera, et cetera. But anyway, this particular announcement has some strong numbers in it, in my opinion. Underlying NPAT of 42.1 million. But here's the key one. So one new store opened during the year, our third store in New Zealand. But the real thing is the online sales channel successfully launched in April 2020. Now, if you go back around about April, you see start to move higher. And I'll get to a larger point about e-commerce and retail at towards the end. But just take a look at some of these trading updates if you're interested in this particular part of the market. They experienced some supply chain disruptions due to lockdowns and that sort of thing. But I guess the main takeaway point is that there's some strong numbers here, and that digital transformation of traditional retailers switching to a more e-commerce oriented sales channel is something I think we'll see more of going forward. So it's sort of hard, and this is a point I make in the article, to specifically say that e-commerce and retail are completely different things. In fact, they're becoming hybrids in some ways, and it's not really fair to pigeonhole them into a certain category, which is a point I make in the article. Now, on that topic, I'll switch to some e-commerce darlings like Kogan Limited. Now, this is a very bullish move from Kogan, and that was sort of triggered by huge sales growth during lockdown. And then it sort of sold off as the Victorian lockdown ended here over the course of sort of October, November. And that may have been people thinking, well, gosh, you know, people will go back to brick and mortar shops, but it started to rise again. And I guess you may see some permanent after effects from lockdown in this sort of long-term shift towards e-commerce. So it's interesting to see it picking back up again. And it's a similar kind of chart for Temple & Webster here. Same sort of large, strong bullish move, and then sort of sold off again, and then is now punching higher. So they do particularly e-commerce furniture. Now, I'll get to those macro trends now. So I'd highly recommend, if you're interested in retailers, to keep a sharp eye on the RBA chart pack releases. So this is how you can get a good sense of macro trends. And you can get this from the RBA website. So the two charts I'm going to draw your attention to here are the household income and consumption chart and the consumer sentiment chart. Now, there are two things to note here. First of all, consumption fell off a cliff and then subsequently started to rise. And then this sort of corresponds with a sort of inversion of that trend in the savings ratio. So lockdown, significant rise in the savings ratio, and that's now starting to come down. And then I'll just look at the consumer sentiment chart here. So you can see a sharp fall off and then a sharp rise. So this is data drawn from Roy Morgan, which is one source. And then I've also got the trading economics data here, which is via the Australian Bureau of Statistics, which is the consumer spending chart. So you have a sharp fall and then it ticking sharply back up. Now, the point I'll make here is that many people might be underestimating the power of a retail bounce. There's a lot of bearishness out there about successive vaccine rollouts, et cetera, et cetera. But the one point I'd make is just take a look at this savings ratio chart. That means, to me at least, that there is a fair bit of dry powder, or the ability for Australian consumers to spend may be underestimated at the moment, given that the savings ratio spiked so hard. So that's just one point I'd make. Now, finally, I want you to start thinking about, I guess, second order effects. So this is a concept from economics, and quite simply, it means consequences of consequences. So there's the obvious consequence in front of you, and then you try as an investor, hopefully, to identify the second order effects from big trends. Now, we've looked at the various RBA macro trend charts. Now, so you obviously get a picture here of a resilient and, I guess, confident consumer sentiment out there in Australia. And that is sort of one of the main points I'm trying to drive home. But then you have to be thinking as an investor of where that money will go after the most obvious things, like say the super retail chart or the JB Hi-Fi chart or the Nick Scali chart, or even the Kogan and Temple & Webster chart. So I'll just draw your attention to one chart here, which is the Tyro Payments Limited chart. Now, all of these charts are from TradingView. It's a good free service if you're interested in that kind of thing. But here you have a stronger bounce off of the March market lows and then a fair bit of sideways trading. But then you see this downtrend here. But if you know what Tyro does, what they do is particularly FPOS terminals, and there's potentially going to move into a more, I guess, fintech-oriented business. Now, that may not happen, but then you see this sharp fall-off. So if I were thinking about Tyro Payments, I'd be thinking, well, consumer spending showing up. What is the second thing that's going to follow from that? And you'd think it could be increased merchant sales at retail places, which you'd then think might flow through to the Tyro Payments share price and their results. Now, that didn't exactly happen, and I'll show you why. So this was the trading halt request that Tyro put out after a FPOS terminal outage. Now, there's a lot of controversy about this. You can also find a link to some articles on Tyro in the video description below, but I won't get into this. But you know, sometimes, especially with certain things like fintechs, for example, technology can be fickle and fail you as an investor. So there's a lot of risk in this kind of sector. But this is just one example of how you should be thinking as an investor, not just the immediate thing, but the thing that comes after that. So I would just remember that consumer spending is popping up, and this trend may continue for a while, especially on a successful vaccine rollout. We'll see how that goes. There's a lot of uncertainty in the market at the moment. Always be aware of the risks, but I hope you really enjoyed this particular dive into e-commerce and traditional retailers. And I just suggest that there will be overlap in the future as they sort of innovate with their distribution channels. So keep your eyes peeled for that. And I'd also just draw your attention to the subscribe button if you like this kind of content. You know, there are not too many people out there doing this, so I'd really appreciate it if you click that subscribe button, and hopefully we can get this kind of content out to more people. Finally, also check out Exponential Stock Investor. This is a great resource. It's a small cap newsletter. I have a lot of fun writing it, and I share some of my best ideas in that publication. So you can find the link to subscribe to that in the video description as well. I hope you, again, enjoyed this, and you can expect to hear from me every Monday going forward. So take care, be safe, and good investing. See ya. Bye.